Hi, hello everybody from the state you love to hate. I'm Mike, and with me is
Dan Ritchie,
and our special guest
is Najee.
Okay, so
it's just Najee.
It's Najee. It's fine.
You're like Prince.
How is that like Prince?
Or like Pink? It could be anything. Yeah, anybody with a single name.
Prince has a last name, I think.
Prince.
It's Prince.
Yeah, it might be Prince.
His first name is PRI, so it's pre. It's
his last. It was Ince.
That's it.
So Najee is a Texas boy.
I'm actually from Texas.
And unfortunately, he got stuck in Jersey like the rest of us.
Welcome. Yeah.
It's a shame, but here I am. Boys.
So what's been going on with you? Anything good in your life?
What? No, nothing good at all. Good? Life all right. Fucking sucks.
Wow.
All
right. Okay. It is very hot out. I know we talked about that today.
Yeah, my ass itches because of the humidity. It's just awful.
But for everyone who can't see, he's itching his ass.
Well, I'm not using my hand to itch it.
No, it doesn't matter. They can't see, so it's really up to
them. Well, I want them to get a clear picture. If they are listening, I want them to get a clear picture of...
In their mind's eye?
Yeah. I mean, there's different ways to scratch your ass without your hands.
Use someone else's hands.
You could.
Yeah.
Thanks, Mike.
Life does suck.
Nah, everything's fine. I'm just working right now. Right now, I'm living in Philly. So, that's also cool. I'm just enjoying whatever my summer is that by working all the time.
I feel like that's a lot more than what Kevin gave us in our last interview.
That is. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, we were like, Kev, how's it going? He's just like, good. We're like, come on,
doing
man.
Okay. We're doing okay.
Yeah.
Alright, so how do we do this thing anyway?
It doesn't matter to me. I mean, whoever wants to start off with a topic can start off with a topic. It's really just a podcast about nothing, so.
Yeah. So if you have something on your mind that you would like to talk about, go for it.
Yeah.
Alright. So apparently Jumanji is going to be a movie again, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What would be some good board games that should be movies?
They should definitely remake Clue the movie. Clue. With a whole bunch of stars like they did the original.
I never watched the original. Who was in the original?
You're fucking up, man.
I might be fucking up.
What's it, Christopher Lloyd? Doc Brown? Is that his name?
Yeah.
Christopher Lloyd. He's in that.
So is Tim Curry.
Yeah, that's it. He's the main character, I would say, as a butler. There's a bunch of stars, but they're older, so no one really knows about them anymore.
So there should be like a current remake or something.
Yeah, that would be great. I feel like it would do horrible, though. Unless it was like, even if it was like a Seth Rogen remake, sort of, with like today's comedic minds. Like Steve Carell in there would be good and stuff like that. But I think it would be really good if they redid that. But what else could you remake? What would you like make Mousetrap? Like, it would be, like, an entire movie of setup, and then the end would just suck, you know what I mean? That's how the board game goes.
We still haven't done Trouble as a movie.
What, you just knock people out? How would you make that into a
Trouble where you press the button or something, right?
Or Don't Wake Daddy.
Who would be Daddy?
Who would be Daddy?
It would be, Michael Keaton.
Like, yeah, Michael Keaton would make a great Daddy.
That would be perfect. Daddy. I mean, if he's not cast as Daddy, I wouldn't see it, yeah.
We haven't done Life as a movie yet.
I mean, I feel like that's just every movie, also, though.
There's also a movie called Life. It's not based on a board game.
That's true, but we can have this sort of multi-timeline thing going on where they can see what went wrong.
Okay.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, almost like a crash. Like, all the things are intertwined. That'd be cool.
Jeez, I'm thinking, yo, what if Life was like the Life board game where you could see exactly where you fucked up?
I'd probably cry.
This is where I went wrong. Fuck.
Right, this was the moment.
This is the
right
moment where everything just fell apart.
You can pause it.
Yeah.
And you can see the realization in his brain.
Like The Simpsons. Yeah. The Simpsons. What was it?
Ralph.
You can see at this moment where his heart rips in half. The frame by frame. Look at his face like, God damn it.
Well, they did that movie Battleship with
Rihanna.
Neeson, right?
Yeah.
It's like, that was supposed to be based on the board game Battleship, right?
Right.
That was like a terrible movie. I've never seen it.
I've never seen it look terrible.
But yeah, it looked terrible.
It looked bullshit.
We need Hungry Hungry Hippos.
Chutes and Ladders.
Chutes and Ladders.
Candyland would be really good. Candyland would be fucking crazy. That would be like a Pixar movie.
Yeah. Oh, definitely. I would love to see... They would make it look crazy, I think.
I would love to see like a Pixar version of Candyland, and then like 7 years from that to be the Tim Burton version, because that would just be insane.
I want just a board game cinematic universe.
What do you mean?
Like how Marvel has their universe and DC has their universe. We need like this board game cinematic universe.
Where they all bridge together.
Yeah, we have like Risk up against Candyland.
Oh, okay.
People love this crawl server shit. We gotta get it going.
That'd be interesting.
That'd be kind of sick.
But you'd have to like discriminate against like card games in the board game universe.
Yeah, Resistance.
What are you gonna say? No card games?
Well, no.
Give them a separate water fountain. Is that what y'all told them?
No, yeah. Well, no. I mean, like Go Fish. It would be like, get out of here, Goldfish. Like, no one likes you. We're board games. You know. Yeah.
I mean, they're making Emoji the movie, so why not?
Oh god. There's a video that I go back to every like 2 or 3 weeks of Emoji movie trailer, but every time it gets cringy, SpongeBob gets shot in the face. Oh. And it's like, I don't know. It's just this fake SpongeBob just getting shot in the face. His whole, just a hole just ends up in his face. And it's, I don't know.
I'm really liking what people are doing with that stuff where it's like the Cat in the Hat, but every time he gets scared, it gets sped up.
It all started with the Bee movie.
Yeah.
And now it's amazing.
And now everyone just keeps doing it with different stuff.
Like, Emoji movie, but every time it's awful, it gets even more pixelated. The resolution gets bad. The resolution gets cut in half.
Every time a bad joke, it zooms in.
I think it'd be great if it was every time something weird happens or something slow happens, they turn back into words instead of emoji. It's like the complete opposite of what it's supposed to be. Yeah.
Is there going to be an autocorrect joke? Probably.
Of course there is.
Yeah. Oh, stupid autocorrect.
Oh, I meant to send this. Oh, no. That's going to be like the climax of the movie. Yeah. You know? He's going to mean to send an emoji and it's going to turn into something else.
When did that come out anyway?
When does it come out? I don't know. Sometimes you're right.
Yeah.
I'm not going to pencil it in my calendar. I can tell you that.
We could just like protest it. Like stand out there. Like no more emoji movies.
Like God hates emojis. God loves words.
Like, put up like the picture of the baby parts, but it's just emojis.
It's the baby emoji. Say,
baby emoji.
Baby's thinking words at 18 days.
Baby's making texts.
Oh, that's great.
Baby's sending you a bitch a smiley face.
I feel like one day that's how we're gonna communicate with people inside of other people. They're just going to hook people up to computers and then just, like, talk to their children before they're born.
Well, isn't it interesting how, like, humanity is kind of cyclical, where we started off as, like, Egyptian society making these, like, hieroglyphics, and then we went into more advanced writing, and now we're back with fucking pictures.
Yeah. It's memes.
Yeah.
Fucking memes.
It's just, like, a dumbing down of society, though, man. That's all it is. How can I convey my point the fastest so people already forget about it, you know? It's just a picture. So. Not to get super fucking...
No, there's a lot to that that I don't want to get into. Yeah. The dumbing down of society.
Next topic.
Because we are very much being dumbed down.
Yeah.
To what cause? I don't know.
Nah, we're pretty fucking stupid.
One of the topics I have written down that we talked about last night was, who would you save from the past? And I put, or the future? And I don't know how you'd save somebody from the future, but...
I don't know. I mean, John Connor. You can save him.
In a fictional world, you could.
I will save Selena, how she got shot by that fan.
What?
I don't remember.
Oh, yeah, the singer. Yeah, okay. So, that's kind of...
Like, did you ever watch that movie?
No, I haven't. I know it's like they praise her, and it was like a tragedy when she died.
Yeah,
like...
she was so fucking dope. And then, I don't know, it just cut... to like the real life and like the real life image of like her getting carried out that hotel room.
Yeah.
I'm like, yo, what if I just locked the hotel room that door? Like,
What's the background story with that? Like,
I don't know. The fan, yeah, obsessed fan, yeah.
Didn't that just happen to some like no name singer down in Florida or some shit?
Yeah,
from, like,
New Jersey. And yeah, she was from New Jersey.
Yeah.
And apparently she played Smash Brothers. I found that out.
It's somehow. A baby game. It's a baby game. For those out there who don't know.
I wonder why that is. Like, fans are so obsessed with people that they're like, "Yeah, I'm gonna kill you now. You can't be mine, so nobody's."
They're crazy.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's yeah. But you think that they wouldn't want that person to die because they want them so much, you know?
I think I would say will in the future.
From, what, from himself?
Whatever happens.
Like,
but what could happen? And what
know.
Would you do?
I don't... Whatever happens, I would find a way to...
Would you give your life for...
would I give my life for will?
Would you, like, jump in... Like, would you jump in front of, like, the bullet or, like, the... The blast like Piccolo does Gohan.
I would like to say I would, sure.
Yeah, but that'd in the situation. Dope.
Depends if I'm in a better life situation then. Like, if things are going better for me.
It's like,
it's like, I don't know.
Maybe I won't.
I finally just got things going okay. Like, I don't know.
I don't want to throw it all away just yet. I'm sorry, buddy. Sorry, Will.
If the course is going as it is now, yeah. At least then I die some sort of heroic death.
Mm-hmm. Rememberable.
Yeah.
But, mm-hmm. From the future, let me think.
In the past, I would say maybe John Lennon.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah,
so he can beat his wife more.
Wow, was that a thing he did?
Really?
Beat the shell of his wives, yeah.
Damn, dude. I didn't know that.
Yeah, he was...
They're a real scumbag, huh?
He was a huge scumbag.
But people love him because he can harmonize.
Yeah, but he's this huge piece of shit.
Yeah.
Like Chris Brown. Yeah. Well, I don't know. I think people just stopped liking Chris Brown because everyone knows. Like, it's common fact that he punched Rihanna in the face and... Actually, not so much of a great person.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. I didn't know that about John Lennon.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know who I would save. I don't have anybody down. It was just a question that I figured I'd bring up. I mean, you could always say any historical figure that died too soon, like Prince Diana or...
Yeah.
Mother Teresa. I mean, she just died of old age and shit, though, right?
But, well, give her some Illuminati.
Yeah, like, I can't save Noah. He had cancer. Like, you can't save him.
But you, if you went back soon enough, you could diagnose the cancer before it got worse.
That's true.
You know? Like, oh, we just found this little tiny blip of cancer. Oh, you're good. You know?
It's like, yo, let's just take care of that, right? No. Yeah.
Bowie's weird, though, because, like, his last album right before he died that he released for Black Star was so good, though. So yeah. It's like, I don't know. Like, he died on a very good note.
I would probably say Biggie. Fuck that. Tupac.
Yeah.
No, Tupac.
Nah, I'd say Tupac.
What? Really?
But you'd have to go back years before he even gets in that car. Like,
yeah, I guess.
I mean, because it started with him.
Like when he's three.
No, when he's like.
I'm going to set you on the right path.
No, I don't want to stop him from being a rapper, but I want to stop him from, I don't know, getting robbed in New York
and
getting shot in the ball sack.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we could try to keep that from happening, because then after that, he gets mad at everybody. I mean, deserving, when you get shot in the dick, you don't, it's like, you're a little more emotional than what you were before.
I feel like if you went back to save him, you would just be like, here, wear this cup, it's made of fucking lead. You're
wear
this
fucking chastity belt.
And he's like, what the fuck, dog? And you're like, nah, don't worry about it, man, just listen
look,
to me.
Trust me on this one.
Nobody wants to be shot in the dick, cuz, like, let's go.
It's like, look, what are you losing from putting this on anyway?
Yeah,
tell me
on,
that.
Dude. Like, what's
it's
wrong?
Like, you know what? You have a point.
Yeah. You just have to rationalize with me, that's all. Nah, I'm not a big Tupac fan, so I would definitely say Biggie. I mean, I don't want to see either of them die, but...
If you had to choose.
Yeah, if it was like Biggie in one hand, Tupac in the other, I'm going
but
to
if
Biggie
you say all day. But if Tupac doesn't die, then Biggie doesn't go back to California.
I feel like he probably would anyway. Don't you think?
Just
like a fuck you to Tupac?
He not that kind of guy.
No.
He was not that kind of guy, nah.
I feel like he would still go back. I mean, how long can you stay away? Like, Ozzy was banned from Texas.
I don't know. If I could stay
away
from New Jersey, I would.
Yeah, man. It's New Jersey, man.
Yeah.
Get away from New Jersey.
Yeah, true.
It's like the black hole of the world.
The garbage can.
Yeah.
You get stuck here.
If you say Tupac, you say Biggie. All right, it's the butterfly
effect. I'm okay with that, but if I had to choose, I would choose Biggie over Tupac.
I'll choose Tupac.
Is there anyone in your life that you would save?
Well, I mean, any family member really in the past, but that's, again, just mostly old age. Anybody in my life personally?
Yeah.
Save people from drugs somehow.
Yeah.
Oh, but then that's a whole mental health discussion that's...
Most people I know that go down that path that need to be saved from drugs, I'm like, oh, they're a druggy piece of scum, you know? And then I don't want to save them. So I don't know any of these people before they've gotten there, so
right.
I can't really... No.
Yeah, but it's all about getting to them before they go down that dark path.
Yeah, but that would be everybody.
Yeah, you'd true.
Have to, like, yeah. Structure their lives from birth. Yeah. That'd be a lot.
Like the fucking Truman Show.
Yeah, dude.
What is like? What if they just put in some path where Truman just started giving them drugs?
That'd be great.
Oh, man, it's another episode where Truman just masturbated for 6 hours.
They're like, I'm just cutting. They're like, technical difficulties every night around 9:30. Oh, man, that's great. Like, how come it always goes out right before he goes to bed? I don't understand.
Like, it's like, oh, that's my... I keep wondering what's going to happen next.
Yeah, like... We're gonna reveal it next month on episode 3000. It's like it's just him jerking off, like, or it's like Truman After Dark is what it should be.
The premium service.
Yeah, it's on Cinemax.
Fucking DLC Truman Show.
Like, but who would want to pay for that?
People. Would.
People would want. Yeah, Truman people pay for things. Yeah, yeah. They pay for anything.
Truman Shrine.
Trumanites.
I don't have anybody from the future because I don't know how you predict that. I just figured I'd put that in there to kind of add to the conversation, but
yeah.
Maybe if I had children.
Yeah.
Save them.
Yeah. For everyone who didn't hear, Mike just laughed hard about that. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know who I would save in the future. I'm sure somebody's going to die. I'm going to want to save them. I feel like a Heath Ledger would be a good save just for him to keep making movies. I enjoyed him as an actor. That's one of those people that, like, they died and I was like, what do you mean? You know, and then like when I see all these other people through history die,
you gotta go back further though and save him from the drugs.
Yeah, well, yeah. I don't really know him personally. He could have been a scumbag, druggy piece of shit. You know, but
he also could have been beating his wife.
Yeah, was he married?
I don't know, or boyfriend. Yeah. I don't know. What? What's he know? Yeah,
was he dating one of the Olsons when he died or something? They found him friends? In like an apartment or something.
I don't know if they were dating, but they were friends.
Yeah, I think it'd be interesting if you could save somebody, but.
Oh, my dog got hit by a car when I was like 13. I couldn't.
Oh, my dog got hit in the car. Yeah, when I was 13.
You choose animal over person?
Yeah.
Yeah, so most people would. That's why, yeah.
Humanity had its fucking chance, man.
Yeah, well, that's a dark note. No, I agree, man. There are a lot of piece of shit humans and not a lot of piece of shit animals.
Yeah.
Do you know is there a piece of shit animal that you might know?
Yeah, there's this one whose name is Harrison.
Every time we see him, we just drive faster at him.
There's this dog that Wiles in Glassboro. He lived like two houses down from me. Whenever I walked down the street, he would be barking from his electric fence. It would just piss me off. And I'm like, yo, you're a piece of shit. Stop it.
Have you guys ever hit a dog?
No.
No.
Have you hit any animal?
Yeah.
I think I hit a bird once, but it's the bird's fault because it didn't fly away.
I killed a couple possums.
Yeah.
I hit a deer. It was like 12 o'clock at night. And I didn't know what to do.
What did you do?
I don't know. He ran away. He
just drove off?
What are you going to do? Look for it?
No, like, of course not. I'm just curious.
I drove off. I had class the next morning. I was like, fuck.
What do you do? If you hit a deer and like it fucks up your car, but like enough that you can drive away, are you supposed to...
You could report it to police, and they will come out, and like the deer still there, they'll euthanize it with a bullet. Yeah.
I know, but are you supposed to like stop that? Like, if the deer does run off, are you supposed to like stay there and like call the police or just go to the police station? Like,
I wouldn't. I mean, I guess I hit a deer, they'll be like, we need pictures and photos of the time and place. You're like, it was last night. I don't know. What do you want to say? Yeah.
Yeah. Well, wish I knew.
Yeah.
Wish I had this podcast then. Yeah.
Well, I remember when I was younger, my mom hit a deer, but it was enough to like really fuck up her car. So
yeah, didn't it come through like the windshield and shit?
Yeah. So.
Yeah. Oh, it was nothing like that.
It wasn't like she could drive away. So it was all sorted there. But.
Yeah.
Like, what if he hit a person? And
then you must stop and call. Like, that's the thing I don't understand. When people hit other people and they're like, I gotta go. And it's like, if you just stay and we're like, they ran out in front of me, then you don't go to jail for the next 10 years.
I think people
just
panic. Like,
I would too.
So scared.
I would too, but I don't know. It's one of those things that you can't really say until you're in the situation, but if all you gotta do is not do what you did, you know what I mean, then you'll be fine. But when people run, it's like, there's easy 10 years, you know what I mean?
Alright, well,
what's your topic of the discussion, Mike?
I have a few. I was wondering, what should we start calling phones instead of phones? Because we don't use them as phones anymore.
Just call mobiles like British people do.
Yeah, but is that going to catch on?
No, because it hasn't.
Well, yeah, true.
Just we got to stop calling them phones because they're little computers.
Yeah, I don't... I mean, I use my phone a lot for work, so I'm on it a lot. But for the most part, I'm like playing video games or interneting and other things. I even use my calculator more than I use my phone, so...
Yeah, I don't know. It is a device. Yeah. I don't know. Communication?
Remember when Pom Pods were a thing?
Yeah.
For like a year? In like 2001?
I remember Jim Griggs had one.
Oh, dude, I remember when Jim Griggs had one. To plan his day of school.
Yeah.
Like, transfer class from here to here. Like, you need that?
We all have to do that.
Yeah. We're all... just follow us. You don't need your hand to vibrate. Like, it is now time to change class. Yeah,
yeah, we all do at the same time. All
right, Jimmy, come in. Pom Pom didn't say so yet. Like,
battery died. I don't know where I'm going.
What am I doing next? Yeah, I don't know what you call a cell phone or a phone, because you wouldn't call it a phone.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm just wondering how much longer we're going to keep calling them phones in advertising.
I think it's stuck. Like, what? What else would we call it?
What happens when it starts, like, you just do a boop? Now, you out there can't see what I just did. I took up the phone, I held it to, like, my face, and I pressed, like, an imaginary button.
He just booped it.
I booped it, implying, like, it's going to transport me somewhere. You know that's going to happen.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it's the same thing with, like, digital cameras. There's no reason for a digital camera to be sideways.
Right.
With the lens to one side, not the other. That was old school film cameras, but it just stuck. Like, that's the way they were designed, so that's the way they're designed now, even though they're digital. Same thing with phones. Like, it's not a phone, but it's a phone, so why is it still that shape? I mean, it could be a fucking circle, you know what I mean? But it's just easier to fit in your pocket as a rectangle, you know?
Guess, man.
Yeah,
I don't know. It's easy to call it a phone. It's hard to call it a communication device
because
you are communicating. You're communicating on the internet.
Yeah, you're communicating using the camera. With the text
messages.
It's more of a camera than a phone. I use my camera way more.
No, it's a fucking everything. All right, it's your life. It's our life now.
Life box.
I still think it's funny when I'm out places like shows or whatnot, and people break out old school digital cameras. I'm like, what are you doing? Then you have to plug that into a computer and then upload it and then send it to your phone to post it.
It's like, why are you making it hard for yourself? Yeah, like,
they're just going to stay on it. You're never going to put them out. Like, what are you doing, you know?
Yeah.
I've never taken a digital photo on a digital camera and then done anything with it except for leave it on there.
Oh,
and then delete it later to take more photos. Like, I don't need any of these.
I took a digital camera on my senior trip, I took one, and I print out the pictures, but I'm like, didn't like any of them, so they're lost in space and time at the moment.
Yeah. That brings up another point. Like, back in the day, you take a bad photo, and you get them developed, and be like, oh, these are funny and hilarious. Nowadays, it's like, no one has a bad photo of anything, you know? I mean, if they do, they keep it because it's hilarious, but for the most part, you don't have that, like, person talking or, like, person not looking at the camera.
That goes into our discussion what we were talking about last night, how people present themselves as perfect online.
Oh, there you go.
And they don't show any of those bad photos. How many times do you think it took that a girl to take that perfect photo? That wasn't the first click.
Yeah,
that wasn't, like, after.
Yeah, like, none of these are candid.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Walk from bathroom to bedroom 47 pictures later. Like, what the fuck, man?
Go ahead, Najee.
All right, so I guess we were talking about last night because I started using online dating, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm seeing these like these pictures of girls, like they're on boats and they're like in the woods.
Look how glamorous my life is.
Yeah, like look how exciting my life is. But it's like, I don't know. I could meet you and be like, oh, you're just a boring bitch who has a boat. Who has a rich uncle with a boat?
So what would you rather have? Would you rather have like scenic mountain view / boat view, or would you rather just have like plain white background driver's license picture, like?
Plain white background. Well, I mean, what?
No.
I kind of want to just see how you look.
Profile says, meet me and find out what I'm like, and it's just a robot.
She needs to be lounging on a couch in sweatpants and no makeup on.
Yeah.
I mean, that's also cool. Yeah.
No, I mean...
Or something candid. Not something so planned all the time.
Yeah,
why does everything have to be set up for a photo?
Mm-hmm.
Like, just live your life and, I don't know, maybe in the future we'll just have someone just... Or, like, we'll have, like, drones flying around that just take candid shots of you. Well, they probably do anyway.
True,
like,
the
FBI keeps a record. Maybe you can buy pictures from the FBI. Yeah. Oh, yeah, Google just drives around with the Google Mobile. Throwing Google Maps.
You just make your walking down the sidewalk picture your profile picture. Like, yeah, I was on Google Maps.
That would be fucking sick.
Yeah.
If I'm just walking down, like, I could probably be just looking like the coolest person in the world. I'm just looking at my phone.
But you're on Google Maps.
And now I'm on Google Maps, and I don't know. And this picture has 120 likes because it's dope. And I'm like, all right, well, I'll put that on my Tinder profile.
Profile Najee was featured on Google Maps. That'd be great.
That'd be exciting. That'd be exciting. Just to be, I don't know, publicized.
It would be interesting if the FBI did start taking candid drone pictures of us, and that was like a revenue for them to sell them back for great profile pictures that aren't like scripted.
Yeah, right? Yeah, definitely.
That's how we make up the deficit.
And like, I'll soon be
the vanity of our American populace.
That's it, man. That's it.
That's the new fucking bonds that people buy, war bonds, but it's pictures of yourself.
Just vanity pictures. Just to fuel your narcissism.
Yeah.
Fucking, I don't know, instead of drones, they'll just get smaller and smaller. They'll just be little Google flies.
Yeah.
Just all in your house.
Mm-hmm.
You could be taking a shit. They'll take a picture.
Yeah.
Gotta see what you're doing. Yeah, it's going to happen.
They're going to take a picture from the toilet, like underneath.
That's not a good shot of your asshole.
That's the new...
What would be a good as shot of your asshole?
I don't know. Not one that's dark and cut. I imagine cover up a lot of light.
I feel like if you unless have a Google have, like, camera vision. Fly, you'd have like some way to illuminate inside the toilet.
It's got the flashlight on. You're like,
what
the fuck?
Why are my balls glowing? Like, oh, damn, Google flies.
New profile pic.
That's not scripted. That's what you need to do. Send some cameras up in your toilet and then take a fucking picture and put it on your Tinder profile.
That's how every great adventure starts. Setting my cameras ass. In the toilets.
This guy, my ass. Want some fuck?
This guy's interesting. All the hipster girls are like, yes, I'll swipe left for him.
He's not the normal everyday guy.
Yeah, normie.
Yeah.
Intriguing. Well, fascinating.
That would be a great way to explain to your kids that, like, yeah, she saw a picture of my butthole and, one thing led to another, and then you guys.
Well, this leads into my great other topic.
Yeah.
About cameras and everything. I know I was telling Dan last night this, but not you, Najee.
Why not?
Well, because I wanted to save it for now. But we were. I was in the bathroom yesterday, and before I got a shower, I was like looking at myself in the mirror, and I noticed I was catching my own reflection in my eye. So looking at my eye and seeing myself reflect, and I was thinking, when we have contact lenses that like have cameras in them, and that is coming. It's going to happen. This is going to be the shit that 16-year-old girls love. That's going to be their fucking profile pictures, like their eye and then them in it because they're
like new mirror selfie.
Yeah, that's going to be the fucking selfies that they do.
Yep.
Jeez.
Well, you said, "Oh, look how artsy I am." Yeah, like, it's not artsy. You're just looking at yourself. Shut up.
Because I was doing it. I was like, that looks kind of cool for a girl.
And then you jumped in the shower and washed it off. You're like, I'm done with this.
And then I almost stuck my hand in to feel the temperature of the water. I was like, fuck, I'm just going right in.
Can't be scared of that water.
There's no water on. Like, fuck it, I'm just going.
Ready shampooing.
Yeah.
Dry.
It's just a glob, man. It's just like paste. It sounds terrible.
Rubbing the soap on a dry washcloth and rubbing it on me.
Oh, it'd be all powdery.
Yeah.
I feel like, nah, that wouldn't help in showering. I was going to say, it might speed up the process, because all you have to do is rinse, but you're still washing, but you're dry washing. Sounds terrible.
Save water.
Yeah, that just sounds uncomfortable.
I guess, yeah, but it also sounds very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Like, I go in the shower just to get comfortable. Like, I don't know. When I'm dirty, it's uncomfortable, all right?
I agree.
Like, I'm all really sticky.
Yeah.
Especially when I come out of work, so I don't know. It's a therapeutic experience.
Do you stick your hand in to feel the water?
No.
I get it set where you just turn it all the way and then you turn it back a quarter turn and that's me. Yeah, you know what I mean?
It's like, I don't know, when you use the same shower enough, you got your little staple settings. You know which ones you're gonna go to.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, to see if it's warm yet.
It'll get warm.
You just go in cold?
No. I just wait like 20 or 10, 20 seconds. Like,
it'll be warm 20 minutes.
Yeah, I was like, oh no.
Like, damn, dude.
At my parents' house, like, being on the second floor and the water heater was in the basement, it used to take like 5 minutes to get warm. They used to just sit down, Instagram a little bit on the toilet, and be like, oh, there's no steam in the shower yet. And then be like, oh, steam, all right, yeah. Now it's like you said, 10 seconds, 20 seconds,
yeah,
hot.
Yeah, pop right in.
Yeah.
Well, you know, so one of the things that I'm following now is R. Kelly having a sex cult.
That's a thing?
Yeah.
I didn't know
you didn't know that?
Was it underage girls or no?
I'm not sure if
does it matter.
It does matter a little bit. It makes it creepier.
It makes it a little creepier, but the fact is that he has women in, like, probably some house that he rents out.
Yeah.
That just, I don't know.
It's just not in his name, though. It's just in, like, his friend's name.
Or something. Yeah. And what? I don't know. Like, one of the girls just went on camera. It's like, I'm not in the R. Kelly sex cult. He's not treating me any type of way. This, that, and the third. And it's like, well, you have Stockholm Syndrome, but that's cool. Yeah. Like, their family staged, like, an intervention for her and everything.
Damn, how'd she get out? Normally when you're in, you can't get out. Is it, like, a compound, or is it
just,
like,
he's probably not a very good cult leader,
alright? You never thought about it.
You didn't know about the fucking Jim Jones cult until, like, they all killed themselves.
Yeah, you don't usually find out until it gets bad.
Alright.
Yeah.
So yeah. I guess it's to the point where it's like, does he frequent the house? Like, what do you know about this? Because I know nothing about
it. I thought you would know more about it. No. I figured you...
Give us the rundown.
This is a great topic.
I mean, first of all, it was like three things that happened last week. Usher Raymond, like, ended up giving this girl herpes, and he asked Sue for like $10 million.
Damn.
Yeah, man.
How do you prove it's from him, though? It's like, I'm broken out, you're broken out, you know, sue him,
I don't know. Yeah. Somehow.
Yeah.
And I guess Kevin Hart cheated on his wife. That he cheated on his last girlfriend or wife with. So.
That sucks.
Yeah.
That's pretty shitty.
Yeah.
It's like me some Kevin Hart.
The juice is loose.
The juice is loose.
The juice is loose.
That is great, though. That's great for society.
The juice is loose.
His antics can only go up from here.
I feel like they should just exempt him from jail so we just have constant news stories that aren't that depressing, you know?
It's like, OG's at it again. Mortal.
He's 70.
Is he?
Yeah.
Damn, that's old. I don't know, he's that old.
He's that old.
Damn.
He won the whatever... I'm trying to think. Whatever we got like that huge notoriety for, it was like 50 years ago.
I don't know.
Was it sports related?
Yeah.
Was
like college athlete.
He won some sort of award. Yeah.
Like the Heisman? He won the Heisman, right?
I don't know.
I'm thinking of. I don't know.
He had like a shit ton of receiving yards and rushing yards or something, right?
But he's been on the map for like 50 years. Like, we've been dealing with him for 50 years.
Yeah, but have we really? I don't deal with him every day.
I do. Every day I visit him in prison.
Jesus.
Like, oh, hi, Mike. Oh, hi, Mike.
You have a visitor, and he's just like, not today, man. Come on.
What's up, man?
He's like, oh,
did you do it?
Go away. It's how every conversation
For the last time, no. But if I did.
I wanted to just, like, break one day and be like, yep, it was me. He'd be like, oh, my God, really? No, go away. Like,
nah.
It wasn't me. No, that's cool. But he's loose in, like, 4 months, right?
Yeah, October.
Well, so he's not necessarily loose, but the grip is tightening. It's loosening.
Oh, okay.
Probation.
It's not tight, yeah.
But does he have to stay in Nevada?
Fucking no. He's loose. That's all you need to know. Loose. The juice is loose.
Yeah.
The juice is loose.
I mean, that's not that bad of a place to stay. You can just go to Vegas all the time. Yeah. I mean, Nevada sucks.
Which is great for OJ. Yeah. To just be stuck in Vegas permanently.
Yeah, like nothing bad could happen in Sin City, you know? Like, fuck, dude.
Well, how do you guys feel about meme page admins?
I'm familiar, so
yeah, you tell me.
Yeah.
You ever been on Facebook or Instagram, and you just see these accounts posting memes?
But I don't ever really visit the pages. I just see, like, the photos.
The post itself, yeah.
Well, there are people who run accounts, and they just have all these memes that they gather from the internet and post them to other people. And it's like, how do you look at yourself knowing that you're just like a meme gatherer? Like, you steal memes.
Yeah, you're not making them.
You're not making a single fucking meme.
Yeah.
And, I don't know, you're putting like your watermark on it and you're just getting a whole bunch of followers.
Because, yeah, I hate that.
I don't know. But then again,
I feel like that's just like regular life, but just on the internet now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, that reminds me of how people take YouTube videos and put them on their meme page, and they don't credit the original YouTube person, and the Facebook post will have 2 million views, and then the YouTube video will have like 50,000.
Yeah,
and like that fucking sucks, and it's stupid. Another thing, you know, what I fucking hate on Facebook with the videos.
Do tell.
They have like, what's up with the fucking video in the center, and then text on top and bottom. I see that all the time.
I'm starting to see that, yeah.
And it's like, why the fuck? Why?
It's like, it's we like don't boxed need...
in, like, and text on top and bottom.
This right. will surely blow your mind.
Yeah, and it's like a video in the middle of it.
Floyd Mayweather and Conor McGregor.
Just watch the fucking video.
Yeah, just make the video bigger. I get the point of it.
Yeah.
Like, yo, stop taking up my space with your fucking commentary.
It's
going to
be, like, bigger and bigger, and then it's going to be, like, that big of a video.
It's just going to go backwards. Remember how we started with hieroglyphics, and then we're back to that? Now we're going to start with videos and go to text, and then go back to videos. That's all it is. Like, no one wants to see anything anymore. We want to read about it, and then it's going to go back to video. So do these admins make money off this shit, or is it, like...
They probably... I mean, I don't know. I don't think they do.
I don't know they how just ads do it for the following. Facebook.
I guess so, for the following.
Like,
or maybe they feel like they're doing a service. Which I can understand if it's like they're doing a service to the fucking community.
The meme community.
Yeah, they're the meme hub.
All that shit pisses me off too, as a guy who wants to like write, and you have people who are just stealing other people's shit.
Yeah.
And they have like 5 million followers, and you don't really even have to invest anything as a follower.
Mm-hmm.
Pisses me off.
Well, why don't you just do that?
Because I don't want to do that. I want to make real things.
Yeah.
Why don't you just make fake things and call them real?
What? You Will Smith's son?
Oh, that's great.
How can we be real if our eyes aren't real?
Oh, sorry. My Pretty ass sure I tweeted something like that.
Get that itchy ass.
God, I'm going to sit down on this couch.
Okay. Right, sit on that couch.
Yeah, can you hear me still?
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
I'm too moist. It's just...
It's worse? Is it better?
I don't know. It's not getting better. Okay. And I'm panicking.
We were talking also last night how Gotham City's in Jersey. But South Jersey, so...
Oh, he's in South Jersey? I didn't know that.
It's like Atlantic City or Bridgeton, usually.
Oh, fuck. Wow, that's worse than I thought.
It is worse.
Oh, my God.
That's what I said. I was like, I can't see it Bridgeton.
I thought it was going to be like Newark or something.
No, it's South Jersey.
I thought it was going to be Camden. You know, I could see Camden, but I can't see Bridgeton.
It is Bridgeton, Atlantic City.
Jesus
I could fuck. Actually see Atlantic City, but there's just not enough, I guess... From my knowledge of Gotham, there's not enough ocean line.
Yeah, that's why I don't count Bridgeton either, but Bridgeton considers themselves to be, for some reason.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, if Bridgeton, you need
like, they had a festival last year, like, celebrating it.
I mean, there's nothing else going on in Bridgeton, so why not give them something?
Other than, like, a, you know, a state prison, but...
Yeah.
Fuck Cumberland County, honestly.
Like, why doesn't Batman... Like, in the movies, go to Wawa and get, like, a hoagie in the comics. Like, stop the Joker from, I don't know.
Just pulls up in his Lamborghini, like, I'll just take a classic Italian. Like, it's Hoagie Fest. Oregano. Tokyo Fest.
Hoagie Fest. Oh, God.
Not the Joker destroying Hoagie Fest.
Exactly. Wouldn't that be a great plot? The Joker is trying to destroy Hoagie Fest.
But it's like everything's tie-dye, so it blends in.
Yeah.
Like, who is the real Joker? Yeah, that'd be great.
Where's Waldo? Joker edition.
That's it, but it's like Wawa Hoagie Fest edition.
Oh, fuck.
I don't know why no one has capitalized on this yet.
Well, now that you said it, someone's going to meme steal that and then turn it into a thing.
Yeah, put their own watermark on it.
They need to make him more of a Jersey guy. I don't know. In South Jersey, and he also, I mean, it's great because he's stuck in Gotham, so it solidifies how we're stuck in Jersey.
Yep.
I mean, why doesn't Batman ever just travel?
Yeah, why doesn't he leave?
Yeah,
because it's his city, man. His dad built the city, right?
Yeah.
Like the Waynes built it.
But you don't see any other rich guy in real life or fiction that cares about their city.
Yeah.
We were talking about that last night. I was saying the fucking... All these sports teams, they make millions of dollars, but don't they invest that back into the community?
Yeah, you say that because you're communist, Mike.
Well, yes.
No, I see that too, man. Like, I'll see rappers post stuff like, this is my $1.5 million wraith. And you're like, well, just give, like, everybody who's in your town in, like, Section 8 housing, like, a house.
Yeah.
Like, you can totally do that, you know what I mean? Like, why wouldn't you do that instead?
I would love to give funding back to, like, Delsey for art shit.
Yeah.
Instead of football
fuck
shit.
Fuck Delsey. Alright.
Well, only because it's my roots. But maybe fuck Delsey. I'm saying definitely fuck Rowan. I ain't ever giving them shit.
Yeah, fuck Rowan too.
But, if you had money, the Bruce Wayne story would be to move out of New Jersey and not support your town. So why would you do that?
I don't know.
It's counteracted
just
your
fuck
own
Delsey, man. I would like to see them bring back arts instead of putting all their money towards football.
I feel like that's every town, though. We celebrate sports and we don't celebrate art.
I would give it to someone under the circumstances that they can't use it for sports.
be yeah. like.
And then if they do, just I'm not making any threats.
I'm not going
to
say.
I'm not threatening you, but you really should.
I'd be
shouldn't.
Very upset.
Yeah. You really should.
I'm not going to take the money
yeah.
back.
I might take, well, yeah, no, exactly. no, no, I'll
you can't say you might. You can't even insinuate that, but just.
Why couldn't you?
It would be, because that would be a threat.
No, it wouldn't be a threat. It'd just be like, this money is for art, and if it doesn't get used for art, it's not your money anymore.
You know I would probably I mean? Just end up, I would just use that money to buy art crap and give it to them.
Here is Crayola. Yeah.
here's like state-of-the-art film tech
yeah,
and computers.
Yeah.
Use that football team, you cunts.
Sports is a really big, like, I don't know, venue for like,
it is, I'm trying good.
To, yeah, but for entertainment, but it is the biggest.
Yeah.
That's like America's biggest export is entertainment, so yeah. why not support the entertainment that we export?
Because there's more to life than football.
I agree with you. I'm just telling
but
you why.
Football's fun. Are you trying to say there's more to life than fun?
Yeah, there is. Like despair.
True words of a
pain.
And pain.
That's why it's called painting.
that was good, but that was a stretch.
No, that's off Always Sunny.
Is it?
Yeah. Okay. Fucking Frank Reynolds.
Is that when he dresses up in that black outfit with the white hair?
Yeah.
Okay.
The Warhol kind of impression.
Yeah.
And I don't know. They made like a mural of it, like on some wall, but it's fucking sick. I don't know.
You got fun is good. But you have to have the bad times, enjoy the good.
Yeah, because if it's always good, then how do you know it's actually good?
Yeah, then it would be awful.
Yeah. I mean, it wouldn't
swing,
be.
I guess it
be
swings
great.
Back. And, yeah.
I don't know. It's an interesting question. You guys want to do any of your top fives?
Sure.
What?
I was just checking the time. You can start if you want.
Yeah, I would like to start with top five horror movies because I don't like horror at all.
Okay, who would like to go first on this?
You go first.
All right. Night of the Living Dead, Dawn of the Dead, Day of the Dead, Land of the Dead, Survival of the Dead, Evil Dead, Evil Dead 2.
Okay.
So anything with dead in it, really.
I like American Werewolf in London. I like the Horror of Dracula. I like The Invisible Man. I like The Thing, The Fly, Invasion of the Body Snatchers.
My list is very short compared to your list.
I'd like to recant and say Land of the Dead and Survival of the Dead are complete shit. Don't ever watch them.
All right.
But The Thing is probably my favorite horror movie.
So your top five is the top 50?
Yeah. I like a lot of horror.
I'm not a horror person.
I'm not a horror person.
What do you got, Nash?
I have Paranormal Activity and Alien and Aliens.
Those are good.
Yeah,
I didn't,
good.
Wait a minute. So Alien and Aliens, they're...
We'll count it.
Yeah.
They're the only... This... Definitely Alien. Aliens is debatable.
Yeah. Aliens is pretty action-y. But it's still fucking dope.
It's still got its scary moments.
Yeah.
I have down The Shining, The Fourth Kind, which was that alien movie about being visited by aliens, which I didn't know was scary until I started
movie
watching
messed
it.
Up, dude.
Yeah, dude, I still lock my doors at night because of that shit. But then I have The Sixth Sense, Signs, and my favorite, Ernest Halloween.
That's a great movie. It's called Ernest Scared Stupid.
Oh, I'm sorry. Ernest Scared Stupid, my bad. Now, I watched that as a kid, daylight out. I was like 5, maybe 6. Scared the shit out of me.
It is a creepy movie.
When the things come out of the
bubbling
the
trolls
goop
are
shit,
very disgusting.
Yeah, they're fucking creepy, dude. Scared the hell out of me.
It's fine now, though, because we're old. They only went after kids.
I've still never watched it. Maybe that's why I was afraid, because I was a kid.
And yeah,
it was like
they make a point in the movie like they only target children.
Yeah, and I was like, oh, that's me. Like,
it's like, whatever.
I fall under his demographic.
Yeah, like if it was like only target adults, I'd be like, this movie's stupid.
I'll just be like wiggling at him. It's old for you now.
Like you're a child.
You don't want a piece of this, do you?
They kill you for being a child at heart. Like.
Being a man-child.
Yeah. Yeah, that's my horror list, though. I don't like horror, though. Not a horror person.
The one thing I just hate about horror is just how half the time it's not scary. It's just trying to get a jump out of you.
Yeah.
Like, it'll be, what, with the music and... I don't know. It's just dumb.
A lot of horror
is not
really
scary.
Bad.
It's just like, when someone comes up behind you, it's like, hey, Mike... You just jump real quick. You're not necessarily scared, but you're just kind of pissed off. That's what they do. They just piss you off. Fuck horror movies. Fuck all of them.
The Thing is good, though. You should watch that sometime.
I'll watch it sometime.
It's got Kurt Russell in it.
the best thing you can do for horror movies is just mute them. Because without sound, it's just not scary at all. They can't get you. Oh, it's not scary.
Screaming intensifies.
Yeah, like footsteps behind person. You're like, oh, I guess someone's coming. You know what I mean? But that's, Ann's dad, Carl, told me about that. He's like, yeah, whenever it gets too scary, just mute it. And I do that, and it works. But I still don't watch horror. But whenever it's on and it gets scary, I mute it. There you go. A little life hack for everybody out there who's afraid of horror.
Well, I'm fulfilled.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Really, Shining Carl. Is good. Shining is pretty good.
Very good.
It's not even scary, though.
I only watched the end of The Shining. Maybe, like, the last half of it. Well, the last hour.
Just when he's actually already You've
never
crazy.
Seen the beginning?
Yeah. No, I've never seen the beginning.
He starts off normal.
Yeah.
That's what happens. He just starts off normal.
Not crazy at all.
Now they can watch it in reverse and be like, this crazy guy goes to rehab and becomes a happy family man.
Yeah, that's great.
He really turned his life around.
It's called the darkening.
He goes on a dark winter retreat.
Yeah.
He finds himself and finds happiness.
This axe murderer really finds a family.
He uses the axe to put the door together.
Skilled artisan. <Yeah. laughs>
Funny enough, one of the things I wrote as a topic was movies that you've never seen the beginning or the end of, but you remember anyway.
Oh man, that's a good one, but like off the cuff.
Yeah, off the cuff off is the cuff. Hard, but there's definitely movies like that for me.
Oh yeah.
That'll just be on FX, and I watch for 5 minutes, and so it's the same 5 minutes I seem to catch it at.
My problem with it is I'll see parts of a movie, and I'll see parts of a very similar movie, and those movies become the same movie. Like
especially
with
the same actor.
Like you with Black Hawk Down.
Yes. Behind Enemy Lines, it's the same fucking movie.
It's the same movie, it's not. Yeah.
Independence Day for me.
You've seen just the middle of that?
I've seen just the middle and the end, but I've never seen the... I don't remember the beginning.
No?
No.
Starts off as a happy family.
He does.
If you play it in reverse, it's about these aliens leaving Earth.
Not trying to take it over, but rebuilding structures Oh, that's great.
So the real villain is humanity.
Yeah.
As usual.
Yeah.
As always.
That'd be a great...
Fuck humanity.
Yeah. Let me think. Shallow Hal is a movie I've... I think I've only seen, like, the end, but I never seen the beginning of it.
Mm-hmm.
Most Adam Sandler movies. Well, no. Just Billy Madison. Mm-hmm. I know the end. No, I don't know. I know the middle, but not so much the end.
Right. Well, just give you a heads up. He wins, and everything's fine. Like most movies. Sorry for the spoiler.
Well, fuck.
Yeah.
Well, there goes my night plans.
I mean, I've seen Shawshank Redemption probably a billion fucking times. Because whenever it's on, you have to watch it, right?
The Green Mile.
The Green Mile. That movie is like 5 hours.
Oh my God.
But it's so worth it. But the thing is like, I've seen the beginning, but I've only seen the beginning maybe once. So it's like, I always catch it when he's like dumping dirt out of his pockets in the yard.
Right.
You're like, oh yeah, I remember everything. It's fine. I'll watch it again. Yeah. But... that's one of those movies where you know the beginning and you know the end, but you don't,
Like, I still don't know why they killed the magic black guy.
Why? Because he supposedly killed two girls?
Oh, wait a minute, and he didn't.
He didn't. He tried to save them.
Yeah.
But they were like,
are you sure? It was black.
Fuck you, Mike. Fuck you.
For all of our listeners out there, Najee is a black man.
You're a piece of shit.
Mike. And is offended by Mike's black man comments.
I remember, that reminds me of To Kill a Mockingbird.
Mm-hmm.
And we read it in high school.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
And we asked the teacher, like, so was the black guy innocent or not? She's like, what do you mean? I mean, they don't ever say.
Yeah.
Well, he was definitely innocent. For a fact.
That's one of those books that we were supposed to read in high school, and I never did. I know the premise of it.
I know the premise.
I read it because we like had to in class.
Oh yeah, I still didn't read that.
I know we had.
Like, there's a lot of the fuck out.
I would just kind of read it or read parts of it or read just like the first 20, 30 pages and look at Cliff Notes and get my little 75 on the test and B on
my life. I did that for all the summer readings, and I think I failed every test every year for summer reading.
Summer reading is bullshit. All right, yeah.
It's awful.
It's awful. It's dumb. It's like, this is the time where I'm supposed to enjoy my life and not think about school.
Right.
Yeah. And
I'm supposed to grow as a teen.
Yeah.
Well, it's bad because I would rather have read other stuff. Mm-hmm. Like, if you tell me to read something, I'm like, fuck you, bitch. I ain't doing that.
Yeah.
But, like, maybe I would have picked up 1984 on my own.
Mm-hmm.
Still haven't.
Yeah.
Still won't.
But there's always that option.
I did read Fahrenheit 451, and I love that book.
Yeah.
That's a great one. And Animal Farm was good.
I remember Animal Farm.
Remember reading a story in grade school, like, third or fourth grade, and I didn't want to read it because it was about some girl and some long dirt road or whatever that she had to walk back and forth to go to school every day, and it was just, like, about her doing this over and over and
was
over.
Was it the Japanese internment camp one?
No, Farewell to Manzanar or whatever. Yeah. No, it wasn't that one. This was like,
I'm surprised you remember the title, because I could not. All I was thinking of Japanese internment camp story we had to read.
No, the only reason I know that is because I didn't read that book.
I read that one!
I had to figure out what it was about, why people were trying to, like, explain their projects in class. I was like, huh, what is this really? Let me read the back of this cover, you know? But no, when I was a kid in, like, third or fourth grade, I read that story, and I wrote on my worksheet I had to fill out, this book is stupid. I don't want to read it. Why do we have to read stupid things? And then I got like an F. Like, you fail. Like, you can't write this. I was like, show of hands, who thinks this is dumb? Like, come on, guys. Like, everyone knows this is stupid. Why are you forcing us to read this shit? You know?
Don't make us read garbage.
Yeah, just don't make us get in line and do whatever you say. You know what I mean? But
I remember failing, getting like a 20 on whatever we had to read in 10th grade.
And you're like, I read it. Like,
no, I didn't read it.
Okay, then, yeah.
It was like for summer reading, we came back and it was like September. So start of 10th grade, and like, I was like, I didn't read this at all.
Like, you're like,
I want to do my best.
We had a book. Yeah. My best is a 20.
Bombed it.
I remember one year, I think it was 7th to 8th grade, we had summer reading, and I was like, fuck it, I'm knocking it out first week. Worst idea ever. You always wait till the last week. Procrastinate as much as you can, because you never remember anything
about
it.
You forget it.
Yeah, I read it. I know I read it. And then I got to the test, and I failed that shit. And I tried to argue. I read the book. Well, clearly you didn't.
Yeah, I did that. Somehow I was able to have Harry Potter as a book I was to do like a test or book report on.
Mm-hmm.
Bad book, by the way, but go ahead.
I read the first one and I was like, oh yeah, I'll do it on this one because, I don't know, I was into playing video games at the time.
Like, right.
I can't write a book on Kingdom Hearts, so whatever. Anyways.
That's when you invent books.
Yeah.
Huh? That's when you invent books.
Yeah.
No, go ahead.
Fucking, yeah, I ended up, so I'm taking a test on it and feeling the shit out of it. And the teacher basically made an example out of me, and I felt like super dumb. Because, like, I was like, yo, I fucking read the book, you bitch. How could
you? That was always the worst when you actually read or studied, and then you still do terrible.
I'm totally not crazy, guys.
No, I love when I would prep for a test and be like, I got this shit. And you get it back and it's like, F. And you're like, what the fuck? I tried so hard. You know what I mean? But that was always the worst.
Yeah. Well, what's the worst month to get out of prison? If you was in prison for a long period of time, like maybe three...
Fucking February.
Ooh. November, because the next month is December, and you have no family and no gifts.
Well, what if you do have family?
Well, then February.
I said January. Yeah. I said January. Yeah. But why'd you say February?
Because January, for me, well, it has my birthday in it. So for me personally, it'd be okay, maybe.
Well, but, that's why I said January, because it's your birthday.
That's clearly.
But I also feel like January still has that high going from the holidays that can just get me through January enough.
Yeah.
And then February comes, and, like, I hate myself until May.
Yeah.
Because I hate the fucking cold. Like, that cold, I hate it.
Yeah, I think I said February because of the same reason. It's cold. You get that little bit of rain, but it's not snow, but it's still cold. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and if I'm in prison for, I don't know, let's say 10 years, and I get out and it's just fucking miserable out, I'm probably going to hang myself.
You just want to go back to jail.
Yeah, like, I would not be able to reintegrate. Yeah, I'm not integrated into society as it is.
Like, you go to jail, you get food, warm food, you get a bed, you get heating.
You get ass.
You get ass. You get booty. You get weights. You get friends if you feel like making them. I don't know. You can have like a little gang or something.
You should be like an inspirational speaker for jails. For sure. It doesn't sound that bad when you talk about it.
It doesn't sound that bad because as soon as you get out, you have bills. You have people who look at you different. You can't get a fucking job because you just came out of jail.
You got responsibilities. Right?
Yeah. And you come out and you come out of jail with none of that and it's cold because it's January. It's fucking whack.
Yeah.
All right.
At least. No. Your parole's set, but you can't get released till July. And it's like, oh, come on, man. I just want to get out now. No. You're going to wait till July. You're going to hang yourself. That's the whole back of
it. I'm very curious if they choose certain months to release people for these reasons.
I guess that'd be a good segue into one of my hat topics that I'm just going to bring up now.
Yeah, bring it up.
What would your last meal be? Now we're talking about jail and stuff.
It depends on how, like, the crime I did and how edgy I am.
I mean, it doesn't even have to be that you're in jail. It's just like you have cancer, you're going to die tomorrow. What would you...
Fucking fried chicken, macaroni and cheese, collard greens.
Yeah?
Yeah. Swear to God.
Chocolate pudding, ice cream?
Nah. I'm not a big sweet
person. No dessert?
Nah, no dessert.
See, if I was on death row and I had like a last meal, I would just make it really, really long. Yeah, one of all, please. All types of
all food.
Never die. Just always keep going. I wonder if there's like a limit, like one protein and one starch.
I don't think so. You can order as much as you want.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I would do. I would order so much food that like I couldn't be killed.
I probably have like shrimp and clams because I can't eat that now.
Right.
Because I'll get super sick. But it doesn't matter if I'm dying.
That would be great, yeah. And then you just die and just be super sick all over.
Yeah, especially if... Well, I mean, it depends if we're going the prison route, or, like, they strap me to the chair, and, like, I'm just shitting myself. Like, as they're strapping me to the end, like, puking. So yeah, they gotta clean all that up, so fuck them.
Yeah, right? If you're gonna kill me, I'm gonna make it pretty miserable.
Yeah, I'm gonna make it a miserable experience for everyone.
It's like you. You in the crowd watching. All right, this one's for you.
Yeah, and...
I feel like I would just start off with, like, the fast food. Like, yeah, I want a pepperoni pizza, then I want a plain pizza, then I want every just version of pizza. Then you go burgers, then you go tacos, then you go everything else down the line until you can't die.
Yeah, but it depends. Like, if I'm in death row because I killed, like, 100 people, like, I'm going to be, like, super edgy and be like, nothing. Dry spaghetti, bitch.
Don't just fucking noodles.
Don't even cook it. Just hand
yeah,
me the
don't
box.
Even fucking yeah. cook it. Just hand me the box of pasta. Yeah. Dry
this,
rice.
This is terrible. I hate dry rice.
It's like, all right, whatever, prick.
You're like, a box of saltines, no water.
Give me a fucking cactus. I'll make do.
That would be pretty badass.
While I'm down here, I might as well just go to Popeye's and give me one of the biscuits.
I'm not a fan of Popeyes, man.
I've never gone, but fried chicken doesn't do well for my stomach.
Your chicken's, but even though the chicken is pretty good, I don't know. I've been having Federal Donuts in Philly. It's so good. Their donuts are so good. Oh god.
How close are you guys to that?
I'm like a walk away.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. My issue with it though is that like. You feel like you're, like, the commercials, they're like, get all these chicken strips and everything you ever want for $5. And you go there, and it's, like, three chicken strips that are, like, so small. It's not a meal. Oh, it's just a bunch of sides. Pinky. Yeah,
it's bad. It's better than fucking Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
Give me chicken tendies.
I always leave. I'm like, how did I break a 20 and I'm still hungry? You know what I mean? So, I'm not a big fan of
fast food's too expensive.
But that's, like, the whole, like... shtick of fast food is to be cheap and fast, right?
It's been getting more and more expensive, it seems like.
Well, when you pay people $15 an hour for...
Whoa. They deserve it.
They do. I'm not
we
saying
We need a living
don't.
Wage.
I'm just saying, if you do
we
that...
Need
you
wage.
No, there's been studies showing that if everyone at McDonald's gets paid $15 an hour, the food, like a burger, only goes up by like 30 cents.
Yeah, fuck it. Do it then.
Yeah.
I'm down.
It's very minuscule, the amount of like...
See, I feel like it's like they should only hike it by 30 cents, but they'll hike it by like $4.
Of course they will, yeah.
They'll be like, oh, it's because they're getting paid.
And they'll blame it on that.
Yeah.
And it's not true.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I feel like the whole premise about the minimum wage hike is... It's just... I don't know. People already want a reason to look down on poor people.
Mm-hmm.
If you get the poor people a little bit closer to being, you know, not poor, they... I don't know. That's what capitalism is. It's just class warfare.
Fuck that shit, man.
Yeah.
We need a living wage. We need fucking a base salary that people just get.
It's
like, here's 30,000.
You're alive. Live. Here you go. Yeah. Gonna do some hat topics?
Yeah, well.
Do you have more to talk about?
I got a little. I mean, I feel like if you're working 40 hours a week, you should be able to afford somewhere to live, food, and transportation.
I agree.
So that's, I'll leave it on that.
Yeah.
But they want to keep. They want to see that seat for the rich people. But
fuck rich people.
Agreed.
The haves. All right, do a hat.
The haves. Fuck the haves.
Fuck the haves.
Fuck the haves.
Naj. Just any. Yeah. They close your eyes because the viewers can tell. Listeners, not viewers.
All right. Has anyone seen Dank Crystals? I know it's Dark Crystals, but I always call it Dank Crystals.
Fucking the Dank film? Crystals.
Yeah. I've fucking seen it. It's pretty fucking dank, I'll tell you that. Is it? Everything in there is purple and green.
Yeah.
It's fucking dank.
I've never seen it, but I heard they're making a remake on Netflix or something.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, it's fucking dope.
Do you like that more than Labyrinth? Be careful.
I know.
Treading on the...
I know.
...dangerous territory. No one heard that.
No one heard.
So what's good about it, though? It's just like another version of Labyrinth, just puppets and whatnot.
Yeah, there's no people. It's just all puppets.
Yeah.
It's very neat.
Yeah. The only... The most I've seen about it is just the Robot Chicken spoof they do of it.
I didn't see that.
No?
No.
It's like they take Dark Crystals, but they try to make it popular for kids today. So they just do like, instead of the Dark Crystal, it's like a champagne bottle of Cristal. And it's called the Dark Crystal. And like they break the bottle and they're like, oh man, we got to put the bottle back together so we can put more Cristal in it. Like that's the whole premise of the show.
That's going to be my Tinder profile.
Dark Crystal?
Yeah.
That would be a great Tinder profile name. But that's the most I've ever seen about it, really. That's the only premise I know about it.
That's pretty sick.
Mm-hmm.
But
what do you like about it?
What do I like about
it?
Well, I like the visuals. I thought the story was pretty cool. I don't remember too much about the story other than they get to point A to point B and rescue the...
Now, do you like Henson movies or just like that?
I like that. I don't remember anything about Labyrinth. I'm sorry.
What?
I remember Bowie's in it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You should rewatch it sometime because it's pretty good.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I remember I enjoyed myself watching it, but I just don't remember the movie.
Do you have a favorite Muppet?
Gonzo.
Gonzo?
Gonzo.
That's who I would go back and save if I could save somebody.
Jim Henson, yes!
Yeah, well,
he died of such a stupid reason.
Yeah, I would save him. That's not where I was going with it, but yeah, I'll save him. I was going to say the girl in Labyrinth when the caterpillar's like, if you go that way, you'll go to the...
You go that way!
Go! No, don't listen to him. Come on. That's who I would save.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Mike, hat topic?
Sure. Let me pick one of these little babies. Old people in stores. Why are they so slow?
That was one of mine. I was at the grocery store today.
Or stores.
No, there's no old people in Star Wars. I mean, like, the Jedi Council, I guess, but...
Fucking...
Obi-Wan's old.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, like, Jedi Council.
Yeah. Wasn't Han Solo old?
In the new one.
Yeah.
I'm not counting.
In the new shitty one.
Yeah.
No, it's okay. I don't want to get on that.
Old people in stores, though.
Yeah, but I was grocery shopping earlier today, and literally there's this old guy who's shuffling out of the store. I get it, you're old. Not a problem. Take your time. You've been here a long time. Take some more time. I don't care. Don't impede me by zigzagging in and out of the exit door when I'm trying to leave, and then stop. He literally stopped in between the doors. Like, the doors would have shut on him if he didn't keep shuffling around. It's just annoying. I love old people. Love my grandma. Don't get me wrong. But just do, like, online ordering. You know what I mean? Like, groceries from online to your house.
Do we see old people worse or poor people?
Poor people.
What about poor old people?
They're dead.
They take care of themselves.
No one makes it.
Yeah, they died a long time ago. They died before they got old.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've ever got... I mean, I'm sure you guys have been in a situation where you're walking behind them and you're just like...
Oh, of course,
God,
yeah.
I have so many things to do. Get out of my way, you know what I mean?
I just cut in front of them.
Because for them, they don't...
It's not my fault you're old.
They might have all the time in the world.
Yeah. But I feel like I don't want to be disrespectful and be like, dude, you got to fucking move. But at the same time, I want to just be like... Fucking move, you know what I mean? Get out of my fucking... Like, I gotta go! Like, but I don't want to be that mean.
Just want to scream nonstop in the store.
Yeah. Like, hurry the fuck up.
Everyone just gets out of your way. You're at the deli counter like, I'm 45. And then they're just like, oh, let's hurry up and get this crazy guy out of here. Yeah. Let me get one of them hat topics.
Yeah, this will be the last one. All right. We've gone, should be over an hour now.
Oh, shit.
I just want to just keep going. But certain viewers of us have told us an hour is too long for a podcast.
Will we get a shift in media output that reflects how much is put out?
All right, can you say that again?
Is this an Najee topic or did I write this?
This might be a Kevin topic from last time.
Okay.
Will we get a shift in media output that reflects how much is put out?
Let me read that.
I'm reading words right.
I get that. I wanted to make sure it wasn't my handwriting.
I don't think
it
is.
I was like, what? Who? I wouldn't write something that dumb.
Kevin, if you're listening, please explain.
Yeah, Kevin, come on. When we get a shift in media output that reflects how much is put out?
Anyone who knows the answer to this.
Let me know your thoughts on that, Najee. All right.
When we get a shift in media output...
See, it's not just me. Those are the words.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yes?
Probably not. We'll probably just stay blind to media output. Reflecting
what? What does that mean?
Well, where media is like, we need to stop this. Like, we're putting out too much bullshit.
Maybe.
Huh?
Let's get another one.
We'll do a different one.
Let's do a different one.
Favorite 90s pop band.
Oh, wow.
I wrote that.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
That's your handwriting.
It is.
This is a much easier topic than...
It is.
Output, input.
Yeah.
What's your favorite 90s band?
I guess No Doubt.
Oh, No Doubt is dope.
I don't like No Doubt.
Fuck you, dude.
I mean, I don't...
I like Gwen Stefani.
Yeah, I like Gwen Stefani, too.
I mean, I don't not like No Doubt, but one time...
Tragic Kingdom is such a perfect album.
One time I asked somebody, because they were arguing with me about how good ska music is, and I hate ska music, and I was like, name two ska bands that have ever made it, and they were like, well, No Doubt, and, what's the other one? Anyway, No Doubt was brought up. And I was like, No Doubt's not a ska band. They might have started out as a ska band, but they're not a ska band anymore. So therefore, I don't like No Doubt anymore. You know? Oh, the other one's Sublime. And they're not really a ska band either.
No.
Not in my eyes. They're more of like a reggae kind of band.
But I like No Doubt.
They're all right. I'm just not a fan.
What? If Boyz II Men is... Boyz II Men is...
Yeah.
Yeah, they're pop.
Yeah, they're pop.
Yeah, I go with that.
Otherwise, I would just say NSYNC. Because
not a fan.
They got a couple jams.
No, yeah. I'm not gonna sing NSYNC right. When it comes on the radio.
But definitely Boyz II Men.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Me?
What are you, Dan?
I guess you could go like Nirvana, but they're more of a grunge than a pop.
Right? Yeah, that's not pop.
Yeah. All right. I mean, Michael Jackson was alive back then, right?
He
was
but he's music. Not a band.
He also wasn't really prevalent in the 90s.
Jesus, cut me some slack.
I'm not.
All right. I guess I don't know what pop music really came out back then that I would like. You tell me, since you guys know everything about 90s.
I don't know. I just thought it was an interesting topic of a conversation. Did Boyz II Men do the Every Breath You Take cover in the 90s? Am I thinking of someone else?
I don't know.
You're thinking of that's Faith Evans Diddy.
Okay. And yeah. It was that cover of The Police used to make me so sad as a child.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like hearing that back in like 96 or 7 whenever that came out.
It made me sad because it was Biggie died.
It was just such a... Yeah, it was such a fucking just sad rendition and everything. Like, I don't know.
Right,
it was
right.
Just sad. But that's not pop anyway. But that just... It all popped in my head.
It all popped in my head. Before we end, though, can we talk about the Centaurs?
Yeah, we can. Sure. Right. Yeah.
So last night we were talking about centaurs and how weird they are, right? And it was like, Mike posed the question, if you had a centaur baby, I guess, like, would it feed off of the bottom portion of the horse if it was a man? Or would it feed off, like, the tits of the female centaur?
What? Definitely the fucking tits. Why would it be... What do you mean?
Like, would it feed off, like, the horse tits? Or would it feed off,
human part tits?
Yeah. It'd be, like, standard centaur, like, human... Upper body, horse, lower body.
Where did man come from? So would it feed off the horse tits or the person tits?
Like, would the centaur person, like, go under the mom centaur and, like...
Yeah, or they just...
Or just, like, go, you know... I mean, it's a baby, so it'd be like...
I feel like it would be on person tits.
Yeah. Not just, like, her holding her underneath. Yeah. Yeah.
I think it's funnier if it goes underneath.
Yeah.
It would also go underneath.
That'd be interesting. And then we started talking about different variations of centaurs. And the one that Mike came up with was, like... What was it? Human top, front horse legs, and then just, like, human ass. So it'd be, like, real top-heavy, so the ass would just be, like, waving in the air as it ran with its front legs.
Well, most, it's horse head
and
legs, and then
front.
Bottom half is human.
Right.
So it's kind of just top-heavy, flopping, and the ass is flopping in the air, and it's, like, on our coast on the ground.
But then what would happen if it was just, like, horse head, horse legs, human body?
Like horse I said, head, it, horse legs, yeah. Human body.
Yeah, like what it'd be like two horse legs. It'd be like humanoid horse, right? So it'd be like a BoJack version of a centaur.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, which one would you want though? If you had a centaur, would you want classical man body, horse body centaur? Would you want like floppy man ass centaur?
Or well, definitely not that one.
No, I think that'd be hilarious if it's like we're centaurs and they're just like man asses. Like, do they have pants on? Because I think it'd be way funnier if they didn't have pants on.
I think it's funny
on.
That they. I've this entire time been imagining no pants.
That's what I've been.
Yeah,
no
yeah,
one
yeah,
no pants. Just
balls out,
man-ass.
Just flopping
yeah.
around.
That seems like a fucking Rick and Morty thing.
It would be great.
But it's just the men that way. Like the female centaurs are fully clothed. Like
just it's a reverse satyr.
Yeah.
What they're called, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which I always thought were pretty cool.
Yeah.
They don't get enough stuff. They don't get enough credit.
Mm-hmm. I think the humanoid horse person would be pretty cool, though.
What, yeah. The BoJack one, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, too. But that they got a whole world of fucking humanoid
animals.
People,
yeah, yeah.
Which is also dope.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I'm a big BoJack fan.
No?
I am.
Oh,
big
you are?
BoJack.
It's really good. What the fuck's wrong with you?
I was for first season. The second season, I was like, all right. Third season, I haven't even watched.
That's good.
I like
the
third season.
It.
It's
all three.
I do think it's comparable to the second one. It's not much better than the second one.
It's one of those shows that came out that I binge watched the first season. So when the second season came out, I forgot everything that happened in the first season.
Oh, wow.
And I wasn't like, I'm not going back and want to rewatch it. You know what I mean? So I leaned through the second season, and at the end of that, I was like, I'm not going to do the third. You know what I mean? But. So
maybe
that
one
was,
day.
Hmm?
Maybe one day.
Maybe, probably not.
Probably not.
Yeah. Game of Thrones probably before BoJack third season.
What is the show that people tell you to watch and you're never going to, despite how many times they tell you to?
Game of Thrones.
Like, you never will?
Well,
you don't
never.
Think you'll ever try it?
No, okay. Well, I tried it.
Oh,
I tried
okay.
the first season. I'm like, this doesn't draw me. Like, this is just dumb.
Yeah.
But
I don't like it either, but...
That and honestly, Orange.
Yeah.
It's
Orange is the New Black?
Yeah.
I've tried watching that.
I've watched one
episode,
and I'm like, it's like, oh, it gets so good at, what, the fifth season?
I watched the first three, and like the fourth season was kind of blah. I think it's on the fifth season now, and I haven't even watched it.
Yeah.
I couldn't get into the first episode of that, and I couldn't get into House of Cards.
I couldn't get into The Wire.
I like The Wire, and I do like House of Cards, but it's too long.
Yeah.
It's an hour long.
Yeah, I hate House of Cards. I can't watch. Like, I watched it all with Anne, but, like, the entire time I'm watching, I'm just like, I don't want this on anymore. You
yeah.
know what I mean?
I didn't finish the first episode of that or Orange. I, like, stopped them at some point. I was
yeah.
like, it's not holding my attention.
Mm-hmm.
My feeble, important attention.
It just seemed,
yeah.
It just seemed too much, like, Orange seemed too much like shock porn to me.
Mm-hmm.
Like.
They're not bad shows, but they're just not good.
Yeah.
Yeah,
well, they just don't interest me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wish we had more bad shows, like, well, it depends what you mean by bad. I want more incompetently made shit.
Oh, yeah.
Because
like,
we don't have enough of that. Just, like, the boom
everyone,
mic.
Everyone
the,
too talented and
the
too much
the boom mic
resources.
In the shot, or, like, I don't know, weird
okay.
editing, like,
right.
and smaller teams. Because it's hard when someone asks me, oh, what'd you think of that movie, and I say it was bad. It was like, perfectly made.
Yeah, yeah.
It was just kind of bad, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, we don't have really... truly bad movies make the theaters anymore.
Right.
With, like, shoddy production values and stuff. But I would like
yeah.
to, because that's more interesting. To
yeah,
see,
yeah.
like, someone actually put their heart into something and fail. Or, like, they get it half right.
Right.
I'd rather see that than fucking Thor 5.
It's, oh, boy. It's like Miami Connection. Is that what you're
exactly.
About?
Yeah,
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 yeah.
Which is a great, entertaining movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not made well.
Yeah, it's just not made well.
Yeah.
I'm tired of these polished turds.
Yeah.
Like, with no story or cat. Like, I'd rather watch...
Like, the Marvel movies. I'm just not interested. I like Guardians.
Anymore either.
I like Guardians. But I just have no interest in seeing any of the other movies.
I keep seeing them and I hate them. Except Guardians. I like Guardians a lot. Yeah.
I haven't seen the second one yet.
It was good.
I'll watch the second one probably later.
But I'd rather watch someone shoot something on a cell phone if it has, like, interesting dialogue and character development than
a new production Marvel value. Movie. Right, yeah. Right.
It's like characters really get me hooked.
Also, it's a cash grab.
Yeah. It'll burn itself out eventually. I mean, it hasn't for like the last 10 years, but it will. It always does.
Yeah.
And that's when we'll come back full circle to board game movies. And that's what we'll
take. That's when Don't Wait, Daddy.
What do you guys think?
Michael Keaton's biggest role yet.
What's the next big thing going to be after a superhero movie?
It's going to go to board games. Because they've already done books. They've been doing books for years, right? Yeah. And then they started comic books, and now it's going to go to board games.
Board game books.
Yeah, board game books.
Well, they're making Tetris a movie.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it like Pixar?
I don't know who's doing it, like, but I know they're making a Tetris movie.
Is it like, what's that Adam Sandler movie? That like
Pixels.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is it I don't know. I have no idea.
I need to know. You can't bring this up and not talk about it.
I can look it up, but I don't think anything's really been announced besides they're making it.
They're like, we're making it. It's just all Russian. It's just...
that would be cool.
Yeah.
Like, this really awesome period piece in Russia.
Yeah,
it's,
yeah.
It's, like, super snowy.
It's, like, 1950s, like, Cold War era, and they're like, we have this new technology, and it's, like, it's called Tetris, and it just, like, levels buildings. We just wrote it for them.
I would watch that.
Yeah, I would watch that, too. That'd be pretty
they're
cool.
They're also making a Galaga cartoon.
Okay.
There's a, like...
There's some story to Galaga, but okay.
Yeah, all right.
There's a new the new Sonic Boom cartoon.
Yeah.
Apparently, it's, like, really good. Like, it's incredibly
Sonic,
self-aware.
Sonic and good should not
it's self-aware, it seems.
The only thing I know about that is they did, like, a Chris Chan parody.
Really? I know they did...
John, I don't think you know who that is. But I'm assuming,
I don't.
I'm assuming you do.
Chris Chan?
Yeah.
I'm
He's,
not
like, this guy on the internet who's just nuts.
Hmm. No. It's like all the internet.
He's obsessed with Sonic.
Yeah. Oh, what did he like? Do like fan fictions or something like that?
He did Sonic 2.
They did. As I seen like a clip on YouTube. On
well, they didn't do. So I'm just. He's the guy
but,
who made
yeah.
Sonic 2.
But they did like a clip on YouTube, like parodying the fan fictions.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, it seems like a good show. Like I like when they shows don't take themselves as serious.
Yeah, I like that a lot too. I like that they can poke fun at themselves.
Yeah. Like, they make, like, actual jokes, like, oh, you know what, nah, because I can't get into it, I can't.
And Knuckles.
And Knuckles. And Knuckles.
Sonic Mania looks alright.
Oh, the game? Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah, because they make the game look like the, or play like the older games.
Yeah, and they got the old, they got the people who would hack the game, ROM hacks the games to make it.
Oh,
right?
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Oh, did you, like, I don't know, and I know you were trying to wrap it up, but.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Like, I know you've seen the stuff about Metroid 2, right?
Yeah.
The Metroid 2 remake. And people on the internet were pissed because there's
a... Well, are you talking about another Metroid 2 remake? Or
yeah,
are you talking about
yeah,
the
both.
Metroid DS one? Okay,
both.
Yeah, I know about
yeah.
both of them.
Yeah,
yeah.
Both. Yeah, because another Metroid 2 remake.
Yeah.
Like, the team, like, they got shut down.
Right.
Like, what? Like a,
last year.
Yeah, last year. Like, what, a month or two after, like, they released...
They released the game, yeah.
They released their game. And, I don't know, it's... Like, they made it from scratch, really. And
right.
I don't know. It looked gorgeous. Well,
yeah, I played it.
I was interested in playing it. I'm probably going to play the 3DS one. But, yeah, I didn't know they would actually employ, like, the team, the people who would have.
Did Nintendo employ that team? Or they didn't?
I thought you said Sonic Mania.
I'm saying Sonic Mania did, but the
Nintendo wouldn't.
They didn't employ the other Metroid people?
No.
Now, do you think they're making this Metroid 2 remake to spite them?
Nah, I think they shut it down because I think they shut it down because they were making a Metroid 2 remake.
They were making it?
Yeah. So it's like, why cannibalize itself or...
Okay.
Yeah, especially with your own IP.
So who owns the rights to Sonic then? Is it not Nintendo?
No.
Sega does.
Sega.
Okay. So maybe that's why they would hire him over Nintendo. Yeah.
Well, Sega also, what, they run that Sonic the Hedgehog account on Facebook or Twitter?
And yeah, it's all trolly.
Yeah, it's all trolly.
Very good.
They just don't give a fuck anymore because they know they're bad.
Have you guys ever seen the Chen the Tiger Twitter?
No,
I haven't. I'm gonna look that up.
Well, you should see the comments on all of his posts.
Okay.
It's all like furry obsessed people.
Yeah, that's great.
They're like, fuck me, daddy.
That's
good.
He's just like promoting a new brand of
shit. Yeah, and the comments are just like, oh my god, I'm gonna fuck you so bad.
That's great, man. That's one weird obsession I never understood.
Furries?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't get it.
Like, you know you're, like, I don't know, it's just a dude in a costume, right? Yeah. You're like, yeah, but it's the costume. Yeah, that's weird.
I know Najee's one, so I don't want to hate on him too much.
I'm totally a furry.
Are you a brony?
No.
No?
All right. One of my friends is a brony, though.
Yeah.
Is he all right?
He's okay. He's an okay guy.
Well, then, are they even still a thing?
I don't know.
Because
I don't know if he's even a brony. I just know he's like, yeah. He's like, yeah, I really like the My Little Pony cartoon. I'm like, oh, okay, I guess.
Hmm.
Yeah, in a My Little Pony shirt.
Well, I hear, like, it does do some, like, self-referential jokes and, like, it pokes fun at stuff. But I have no interest in watching
that. Me either.
Like, I just don't want to. I watch enough children's shit as it is. I don't like to watch My Little Pony.
This is true.
Yeah, I don't need to add even more shame.
You guys remember Spaceballs at all?
Hell yeah.
Or Madballs? I'm sorry. Madballs.
But the toy?
Spaceballs the movie? Spaceballs? No.
It's Spaceballs. I remember Spaceballs.
That was the Star Wars
parody. Not the movie. No. It's
Madballs, like the little monster.
Yeah. But that was a cartoon back in the day.
Was it?
Yeah. You didn't know about that?
No, I just remember the toys.
No, it used to be on TV. And I have a VHS off of TV copy of that and My Little Ponies. That's the only reason I know about it. It's because my sisters used to watch My Little Ponies. But I used to watch the Madballs all the time. It's great. That's one they should bring back.
Let's bring back Madballs and Pogs.
I think they might be I think they might be bringing that back to Netflix, actually. But
Madballs?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah, my sister sent me a link to that, like, months ago, like, how they're going to revamp the series and bring it back. I was like, that's pretty cool. Yeah.
I don't know. They're revamping Hey Arnold. Or they're just making, like, a new
They're making movie. A TV movie of that in Rocco.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, I'm only hearing about the Rocco one, but I just seen the thing for Hey Arnold. Looks good.
The trailer's out for Rocco too. I haven't watched the Hey Arnold, only the Rocco one.
No. But it looks I haven't seen either of those. That's pretty cool.
Just came out, I guess, Friday or yesterday because of Comic-Con.
Oh, right. That's cool. It'd be cool if they kept it the same animation style, like not crisp, like old and grainy. And
Rocco seemed pretty crisp. I don't know about Hey Arnold.
Hey Arnold's super crisp.
Yeah.
I also prefer the old grainy look of things.
I'd rather it just be classic instead of like all digital.
Speaking of animation styles, and I know y'all not big on anime, but
I mean we both like anime.
Well, yeah. I don't know if you follow Dragon Ball Super.
I do.
I watched like 5 or 6 episodes this season, but I kind of
not that good. But it's new Dragon Ball from Akira Toriyama, so I'm just like, okay, so I'll watch it.
Yeah,
and basically it's just DeviantArt Super. Like, the animation is actually garbage most of the time.
Yeah.
Like, it got better. Like, it's at episode 100 now. Mm-hmm. And animation's okay. It's pretty decent now. But it's like, you watch Dragon Ball Z, you even watch GT. And it's just like, it's leagues apart.
Yeah.
So, that's a shame.
But it's because everything's digitalized and they have these, the techniques are different. Because one episode's fast and not more quality.
Mm-hmm. I'd rather keep it old school, though. Keep it to its roots.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I like when they up the value when it goes to TV and shit like that from back in the day, but do it like it was,
But that's just for, like, that's so you get the same feel.
Yeah. That's why I want the nostalgia.
I like that nostalgia. I mean, we can add up filters.
we'll do it in post.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I hate the, like, I don't know about your TV, but a lot of modern TVs, like, it has that weird depth, and I hate it.
Oh, dude, it's so annoying, dude. I can't watch it. Yeah.
It takes me out of it.
I'll go to certain people's houses and be like, dude, this is weird. What's wrong with it? Yeah. Like, what are you talking about? It's fine. But, like, the background doesn't move, but the foreground's super fast. Yeah.
I hate it.
So annoying. I don't have this problem with our TV or my older one, but some of the new ones, I don't know if it's the LEDs or...
It's something.
Or the crystal ones or LCDs.
Makes me not want to watch anything.
Yeah. No, it's weird. And it's not like live action shit either. It's only like movies. Like where they've either compressed the data and it's like they're trying to save.
Some like TV shows I saw it too.
Really?
Yeah.
What was the thing I heard? Like they made Seinfeld like, what, 8% faster or something like that?
Yeah, they made it a little faster and took out time for more commercials.
To make more money.
Like, they cut off, I think, a minute of each episode to make.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Well, Well, they just, like, the cutscenes are faster, or there's less, like,
after I think the both, they speed up some scenes up a little bit. They cut wherever they can time.
Of course, yeah. It sucks.
And I definitely noticed that, because I was watching an episode a few months ago, and they didn't do one of the jokes. I was like, I know every time he says this after, and, like, it wasn't there.
Was that for TBS now they do it, or?
I guess so, yeah. They're the only ones to Laren, I think.
They should stop syndicating it and just play them all, you know, play every episode.
There should be a Seinfeld channel.
Yeah. I mean, people will watch it. It would be like Seinfeld and, like, Mets games. That's all I would play on there. It'd be great.
Curb's coming back.
Oh, yeah.
I heard about that.
Do you watch Curb?
No. You know what? As I love Curb, I haven't watched enough of Curb.
You should watch
it. No, I should, and I would love to watch more of it. I just have it. I don't know. I definitely watched the first season. I've watched the sixth season. I watched some of the second, some of the third, a little bit of fourth. I don't even know which seasons I did or didn't watch at this point, but I know for a fact I watched the first and the sixth.
It's,
and
they're amazing. I
it's
love
amazing.
It.
It's great.
Curb and Seinfeld has, like, the most influence on my writing, I feel like. Because I'll just make that, but then I put it in a fucking sci-fi setting or something. Like, right. BPAC, I imagine, would be like Curb episodes, but just put monsters for some reason. For no reason, but, like, I go for that style of dialogue and everything.
Right.
And everything always comes back in Curb and Seinfeld. Like, they set up something at the beginning of the episode and it always comes back.
Right. By the end of the episode, they're ending with that scene that they talked about earlier.
Yeah, and I always love it. Like, it doesn't get old for me for some reason.
You're like, I know it's coming. And then it happens. And you're like, there it is.
And it's funny every time.
Yeah.
But, like, I hate formulaic shit like Law and Order.
Mm-hmm.
Law and Order, SVU, SVU's a staple. SVU's a staple. Alright. You can't hit on SVU. It's just so, I don't know. It's just something about it.
I haven't watched it.
It's like every Saturday bowl of cereal on SVU. Gotta have
my sister will watch Law and Order all day.
It's adult, like, Scooby Doo. Alright? That's what it is.
It is adult Scooby Doo. They don't tell you, there's no hint strapped at all. And then at the end of the episode, they're like, do you know who did it? Because we do. And you're like, no, I don't fucking know. Just tell me.
It's the one guy who introduced this episode.
Yeah. It's the one other guy than who the victim is. Yeah.
Which I guess is why I like Seinfeld more, because it's. I'm comparing way two different things.
Yeah,
I meant the formula of things, because with something like Seinfeld or Curb, is the same cast of characters.
Mm-hmm.
So it's always them getting into these weird things. But when you have something like a Law and Order, it's like a guest of the week. Like,
yeah.
It's probably him.
Usually is. Yeah. I got you.
Well, I guess we're going to call it here. Yeah. We've been going for a while. So thank you all for... but listening to the Peachcast episode 4 with myself, Mike, and
Dan Ritchie,
and
Najee,
and we'll see you again sometime. Thank you. Right. Have a great day.